it's easy to spot Mackenzie Johnston. On the court, she's the leader of the Lady Grizz basketball team, but it's arguably easier to find her off the court. In the far corner at Dahlberg, just outside the locker room with a fan club even pro teams would envy. Dozens of young fans, mostly female, swarm straight to her after games, while her family, which is also large in numbers, waits patiently nearby, proudly smiling from ear to ear.
That's the type of legacy I want to leave here. I want people to know I embraced this opportunity as much as I could. You're on a platform where you can make a difference in kids' lives. That's what means the most to me. When I can hang out with kids and they're just in awe of you and you don't understand why. I mean, it's crazy the type of impact you just make, giving them a hug and just everything, and going to schools and talking to them, and they get so excited when they get to come to games, and it's just been a fun experience.
Included in the hundreds of athletes that have looked up to Mackenzie Johnston in her career is younger brother Parker, a senior at Helena Capital.
A lot of kids look up to her. She has a lot of younger fans just always waiting for her after a game. I think she could still beat me. She's strong, probably stronger than me, honestly.
It's been fun watching him play. Him and I, we battled all the time, just from even in the basement playing Nerf ball, all that stuff. It's been fun. I've had great role models with my oldest sister too. And I mean, she didn't play college ball, but she was a rebounding machine in high school, and I think I got some of her instincts there. But no, I'm proud of my family, and it's just they've developed me. They've made me into the person I am today.
Ironically, hoops wasn't part of Mark and Sherry Johnston's life until their oldest daughter, Marky, started playing. Then Jordan, Mackenzie, and Parker joined the fray, and hoops is now completely taken over.
My sisters kind of got me into it because my parents did not. I don't think they played basketball ever. Definitely weren't good at it, I know that. But yeah, they definitely got me into basketball.
All four siblings played high school ball at Capital. Jordan then continued her career at Carroll College.
She was my role model growing up. She was a post, but she was an undersized post. So she stopped playing me in one-on-one pretty early. She said she was too busy, too tired, and now I understand. When she was in college, I'd always want to play with her, and she's like, I can't, my body can't take it. I'm like, are you kidding me? And now I understand. But she was just such a hard worker. She was a great leader, and when I have questions, I go to her on how I should approach things, how I should approach the team. So she hasn't stopped being a role model for me.
But as quickly as basketball became a priority in the family, it suddenly reached the potential end of an era. Mackenzie and the Lady Grizz are headed into the Big Sky Conference Tournament in Boise, while Parker and Helena Capital are headed to the State AA Tournament in Bozeman. His career is guaranteed to come to a close this weekend. He's off on a football scholarship to Tech next year, and Kenzie's hoop status is uncertain. Lady Grizz trying to claw their way into the postseason, and there's also the prospect of playing pro ball. But right now, that's not the priority.
I can't imagine it with my parents not going to games. It's hard to picture next year when Parker's playing football and they don't have any more basketball. I don't know what they're going to do.
Yeah, it went by really fast. It'll be really weird. Weird for my parents just not going to any more basketball games. Just now it's just football.
For more than a decade, basketball fans in Montana have grown familiar with the Johnston family. From Marky to Jordan to Mackenzie and Parker, they've recognized and respected the game. But what have fans missed with the family off the court?
I used to pretend I was a werewolf for the longest time till I was about 12. I'd run around the house barking, cuddle up to my parents, like scratch them, lick them. It was weird. They still tell stories about that.
Movie? Or like, do you even remember where that came from?
No.
No idea. Every night I'd transform. It was weird.
I have a really bad shoe obsession. Bad, and I can't stop buying shoes.
What are we talking? Like 30, 40?
No, it's up there. I probably have like 40 Nikes or tennis shoes. It's probably getting close to 100 now. It's a problem. I was talking with my friends. I'm like, I don't know what the best way to sell shoes are. And then she's like, do you want to? I was like, no, I don't want to sell them, but maybe someday when I need some money. But yeah, it's kind of an expensive obsession.
Hush, might make the perfect gift 5 or 10 years down the road for that young fan club when it's their turn to carry on the legacy. Richie Melby, MTN Sports.